Yes. What is it they you think they expect from the United States in 2011 and 2012 after all that has taken place, the economic collapse that we had, the wars that we engaged in, and the two that we are still engaged in different levels? Mm-hmm. What does the world want from America?
Well, leadership, I think, is the short answer to the question. But if we can start with Asia and go to Europe and go to the Middle East. In Asia, they want the United States to be present. They want a United States they can count on to meet its obligations and promises to allies and partners, and we have been doing that. You know, it isn't a mistake that Secretary, well, not a mistake, it's not a coincidence that Secretary Clinton took her first trip as Secretary of State to Asia, first time that's happened since
when she's back in India as we speak.
Since Dean Rusk in 1961. Right. And we have really engaged. Like they want U.S. presence. I think the Asians want to see the United States there engaged. And, by the way, they want us to manage the relationship with China in a positive and constructive way.
And do the Chinese at the same time fear that we are, in a sense, want to be too big a player in the region and, you know, looking at the Secretary's speech in Vietnam, for example?
Yes. That's a very good question, and it's one that's debated in China. And I'd answer it this way. The Chinese recognize, and I've spent a lot of time with the senior leaders of China over the last 2.5 years, and there's a very interesting article on this, by the way, published by their state counselor, Dai Bingguao.
Right.
And for those of your viewers who don't have the Chinese Foreign Ministry on their listserv, you can read about this in the last chapter of Henry Kissinger's book on China.
Right, right.
A fascinating discussion of this.
He's the most prominent person in Chinese foreign policy,
yes.
And he also is a participant in the SED dialogue.
Exactly. Right. So there's a debate in China about this, but I think this is the discussion we have with them.
Okay.
The United States, for over half a century, has been a force for security and stability in Asia. Indeed, the platform on which Asian prosperity has been built, and the Chinese know that. And they have been a big beneficiary of that. And if you look at the joint statements that we've put out with the Chinese over the last 2.5 years, and President Hu Jintao and President Obama have had 9 face-to-face meetings, you'll see a reference to that. And they understand that it's critically
important. They accept the fact that the United States will remain
power,
a Pacific power.
A Pacific power. And it's important for us to demonstrate that we can do that.
Join us online at charlierose.com.